All right, welcome back to the 7-day word challenge for our spouses and married couples out there. This is day number 4, and husbands, we're going to start off with the husbands this fourth day. And one phrase you can use, we want you to use and share with your spouse this week is, "I desire you." Let your spouse know, let your wife know that I desire you. You know, I got a scripture that I want to share with you regarding that. Psalms chapter 73 and verse 25 says, "Whom have I in heaven but you? And there is none upon earth that I desire besides you." And of course, this song is directed toward God. But that's one thing I like about God. God is a very poetic. His word is very poetic. If you want some, as they used to say back in the day, you know, if you want some good love talk, you can get a lot from the scriptures. But let your wife know that I desire you. You know, besides anybody on this earth, I desire you. And it's not about, you know, anything but her. You know, I think about often, we're really, I enjoy it. You know, I think about often about how kind and how loving my wife is. You know, because in this world, you know, as men, you know, we have a lot of things coming at us. You know, it's a lot of women that may be desiring to cheat, you know, with a married man, you know, so we have all these type of temptations and stuff. So as men, it's important for us to, you know, to cast out those thoughts of fantasy and all those things like that. Cast those imaginations down and think about your wife. Think about how much you desire her and the reasons why you desire her and the reason why you marry her. And those things can get you through. And when you get home or whenever you get a chance, let your wife know that I desire you, baby.
I love it. I love it. I love it. And wives, today, you're going to look deeply into his eyes and tell him, "I need you and thank you." And I don't mean just that need, like, "I need you to take out the garbage. I need you to come and change the light bulb." But I'm telling you to let that man know, "I need you. There is a dependability within me that I know that I need you to help me, for us to come together as teammates, as partners. I need your shoulder. I need your arms wrapped around me. You are my safe place." And that's what you really say to a man, to let him know when you really need him. Again, not for a task or a chore, the honey-do list, but I want you to look into the essence of who he is as a man and say, "I need you. There's a part of me that I know I can't accomplish without you." And I'm telling you, that shifts the whole dynamic of your marriage. And when he does finish that need and accomplish that need that has to be met, thank him. I mean, just a simple thank you. That's when you can start doing the thank you for the task. Thank you that you took out the trash. Thank you that you put gas in the car. Thank you that you, you know, painted that room. You know, thank you that you did whatever that thing is that he does. And do that on a daily basis. Let him know the need and the dependability that you have for him. But also thank him for the little things that he does as well as the big things.
All right. Well, we'll see you all next time for day 5.